Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. This is the fourth of the four devlog videos that I'm doing today. This one will be on the HMS Grafton H89. The reason I didn't do any of these videos yesterday or earlier today was because I have had no internet. So of course that's when they decide to drop a shitload of devlogs right on top of each other. I covered the JU-288C first today, then the Type 75, then I covered the HMS Armada in the last episode, and now we're going to look at the Grafton, which is another new of the, I believe, vessels coming with the British Tech Tree. One of the earlier destroyers, I would assume. Briefly, it is a British interwar destroyer comparable in performance with some of the other early destroyers that are present in War Thunder. Here are some of the histories on the vessel, if you care. So definitely not as pretty as the Armada, that's for sure. You got single gun turrets, it's a bit more bulky and not as pointy or narrow. It's unfortunate, but it's got a very nice color to it. I like this dark steel color it's got going there. Get a look at it. They're showing us its ass right away. Like, they don't even care. Wow, okay. Don't even get to know about the ship. In War Thunder, HMS Grafton will be among the first destroyers players will be able to obtain after progressing through some of the earlier ranks. The ship is operated by a rather small crew of 146 sailors. The ship's propulsion system is cranking out 34,000 horsepower, bringing the ship up to a top speed of 31.5 knots, 58 kilometers an hour. It's not a bad-looking ship, though, I'll give it that. But I think it's a little bit lesser in visual style than some of the other nations' vessels. I'd go as far to say even Russian destroyers look better than this thing. But that doesn't mean anything because the Armada is fucking kick-ass looking. The primary armament of HMS Grafton is once again comparable to contemporary destroyer design, comprising of four 4.7-inch 120mm cannons spread across single mounts on the bow and after end of the ship. The Grafton packs a respectable punch and it's able to comfortably take on destroyers of similar rank and smaller vessels. For larger fish, careful, because tuna might be dangerous. Grafton is also equipped with two quadruple 21-inch 533mm torpedoes. Oh, this is for hunting whales. Okay. Launchers mounted midships for excellent firing angles on both sides. The anti-air protection consists of only two quadruple Vickers heavy machine guns, turrets situated behind the ship's bridge. Therefore, future captains of the HMS Grafton are advised to stay close to allied ships with better AA capabilities in order to stay safe from air attacks. Oh, and here you can see they show, like, there's a little tank. So it's very large, obviously. Even though it's a smaller ship, it's still large compared to a tank. I mean, a fucking patrol boat is, like, 10 times the size of one of the big tanks in the game. Okay, that's an exaggeration, sure, but you know what I mean. Yeah, you can see a nice look of the really awkward freaking machine gun setups and torpedoes there. And a nice rear view of the vessel from a different angle. HMS Grafton will be available during the CBT of War Thunder's Royal Navy to all aspiring commanders of this vessel as a rank 3 British destroyer. Make sure to give HMS Grafton a try as you progress through the ranks of the Royal Navy, and be wary of torpedo attacks. All hands on deck. Okay, guys, so that's going to bring the four devlog videos to an end today. Let me know what you think of the H89 in the comments below. Are you excited, or are you more excited for the other British vessels? Or do you not even give a shit about the Royal Navy, and you're just more excited about something else? Let me know down there, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video. Yay!